We all want to be rock stars when it comes to our job, but it is sometimes easy to just slip into that zombie situation at work. So how can you keep that rock star mentality? Morag Barrett from Sky Team in Broomfield is here to explain. Good morning.
Good morning.
So how do we know if we or someone we know at work is at risk of really slipping into this?
Well, we all have our off days, so let's acknowledge that from the start. My colleagues at Sky Team will tell you I don't do early mornings. I can be zombie-like if I'm getting up at 5 a.m. But look for the pattern. If you're no longer looking forward to going into work, maybe you're not focusing, putting off the work you know you should be doing, or maybe avoiding attending meetings or not contributing in those meetings as you should, those are usually the warning signs that you're slipping from rock star to zombie.
Okay, and so what can you do then if you are the employee and you feel this happening to yourself?
Well, if you've lost your vim and verve for life, then my advice is, first of all, pay attention. So if people are stopping by and saying, hey, are you okay? You don't seem yourself. Usually that's a warning sign that you need to sit up and take notice. Don't just brush it off. But connect with what does inspire you. So whether it's a passion that you have, a hobby outside of work, but also seek out opportunities for volunteering, getting involved in different projects at work, and that can help you reconnect and find your excitement for your job.
Yeah, and I know that a lot of people, they might have different kinds of projects every couple of weeks, and then other people, they do the exact same thing every day. And
yes.
I imagine that that might be more of a battle for those kinds of people.
Yeah, so if you see an opportunity to improve how your job is done, discuss that with your boss. Find a way to get involved, and that can help you stay engaged and enjoy going into work every day.
And what if you are the boss and you have employees who you think maybe, you know, are less interested in their job than they were this time last year?
Well, don't ignore it. Better to have a conversation now and find out what's going on for that person. So do what I call stay interviews. They're regular conversations about what gets you excited, why do you come to work, what frustrates you about your job, and the most important question of all is, what's one thing I can do to help your success or our success? And that's how you can pick up on frustrations before they cause somebody to walk out the door.
Yeah, and it can be hard to just stay excited, I guess, if you do the same thing every day.
It is, and the logic of the job, the importance of what we do is only part of the equation. If you're the boss, help your employees to understand why they do it. So connect the hearts and minds, and that is how you build rock stars versus nurture zombies.
Okay, good advice. Thank you, Morag, for coming in. We appreciate it. Back over to you.
All right, we're coming up on 8.